Welcome back to the tutorials on articulate storyline. That indeed was a fantastic time we had discussing setting the story size, and we are going to resume from there. I'm opening the file part 2, and we are going to take a look at the dimensions we had set. 766 by 507 is what we had settled for, providing for all the navigation controls such as menu, previous button, next button and all that stuff, right? Now, before we start our discussion, let's save this file in its designated place as something else. I am going to the tutorials. I am going to call this design the screen, and I am going to call this part 1. Okay, all right. So now we are back to the dimensions. I am going to make some changes on this. I am going back to the previous dimensions we had, 1006 by 582. You remember, these are the screen dimensions we need to have if we want screen resolution of 1024 by 600. You remember that. So we are going to start from there. Okay. Now, before we proceed, I want to uncheck all the navigation controls that we had enabled in the second part of our discussion. And I'm going to tell you why now. I'm also going to the player settings. I want to uncheck menu. Okay. I'm unchecking that. I'm unchecking resources. And we don't want volume either. I'm just holding the seek bar because we are getting into some real-time situation. And once we publish this as a course, as a screen, we should be able to let the learner pause the screen wherever they want. So that's the reason why the seek bar is enabled. Okay, so we are set. Now, I need to tell you, before I proceed, I need to tell you why we uncheck these navigation controls. If you check the navigation controls, there is nothing that you need to worry about, because the tool takes care of all the navigation as long as the buttons are there. There is nothing for us to worry about. But the tool also gives us the option to set the course we want, the way we want, including the navigation buttons, because the navigation buttons can be chosen to be in sync with the background, with the color scheme and all that. So that is what creates the course, that's what makes the course look absolutely unique and beautiful, right? So that is where lies the challenge, that's where lies the excitement of making this course, and that's the reason why I have unchecked all the navigation controls. And we will come to discussing the navigation controls slightly later. For the moment, we are going to see how we are going to design the screen with something, right? We will start with a scenario. We will take up a sentence. It's going to be called, it's going to read something like this: the ability to communicate effectively is the bottom line of any business endeavor. This is what we want to discuss on the screen. So how do we treat this? We have a blank white screen, so we can bring in any kind of a media that we want. So what I'm going to do is to go to this insert. I'm going to click insert, and I see so many plugin options. I can bring in video if I want. I can bring in a flash unit. I can bring in a web object. I can bring in a character. Whatever that I want, I can bring in. Now, for the moment, I choose to bring in an image. I bring in this image. To me, this image conveys what I want to say perfectly well. The ability to communicate effectively is the bottom line of any business endeavor. This image is doing the job, and my job is done. There is nothing else that I have to do. Assuming that I have the voiceover happening on my headphones, I don't need to even have the text on the screen, right? Just this image and the voiceover telling me whatever that we are discussing now, we are on. We are perfectly fine. The only thing that I want to do at the moment is to treat this image for the screen, because I see only the borders happening on the left and right, and to me it's kind of looking imbalanced. So what do I do? I use this crop tool, okay, and I am clicking on this small little black line, and I'm dragging the image to whatever level that I want. Click outside the screen, the image is cropped. I am aligning it to the center. It is already aligned. I am aligning it to the middle of the screen. Beautiful. Really nice with this wonderful background, this border happening around it. It is enhancing the image, and the voiceover is telling me that the ability to communicate effectively is the bottom line of any business endeavor. The communication is done. There is nothing else that I need to do. Right? See, it is as simple as this. It can be as simple as this. Now, let's go to the second step. What if we don't have the voiceover? Then what do we do? If we don't have the voiceover, we need to bring in the text on the screen, right? That is the only way. So we need to bring in the text. I am going to insert, clicking the text box. I am populating the box here, and I am going to key in the sentence. The ability to communicate effectively. I'm going to pause here because I'm not able to read what I'm keying in, right? So I'm centering it. First thing I'm going to do is to make the color of the font white, so the readability increases, but it is still getting camouflaged against those white patches of the image. So I think that probably if I'm going to color this text box, the readability will be much better. It seems like a good idea for me. So I go to format, I click shape fill, go to move fill colors. Though I can choose to have any of these colors, I still would like to have a color that will be harmonious with the background. So I am choosing this pick color tool. I take this wherever I want. I see the highlight happening in this box. Okay, so I choose to have this patch, right? I'm saying, okay, wow, the text box is colored and the readability is perfect and it is adding dimension to the screen and it's looking beautiful. I have added one more element to the screen, bringing in some color to the text box. I am going to continue keying in the sentence. The ability to communicate effectively is the bottom line, sorry about it, is the bottom line of any business endeavor. All right, it looks cool. Now, I want to also treat this font, okay, I want to change it. I want to choose DIN Pro Condensed Light. And I want to set it to 24. Okay. Now, this is once again your call, right? You can choose to have your font, you can choose to have your image, you can choose to have the image either the way we have set it up, or you can also make it full screen by changing the dimensions of the screen, bringing it to 1006 by 582. You can do that. It may not come to that dimension exactly. That is where you need to crop the image to the needed levels and changing the dimensions. You just play around with it. The whole thing will reveal itself to you. All right. So back to the font. This is what I have picked up. I have set the text box. You now see that I'm just setting it up a little bit for the screen because it's hiding the fingers here, and to me it is not looking all right. So I'm setting it up like this. Now to me it looks fine. It looks balanced. What do you think? Don't you think it looks great, guys? I really think it looks good. Yes. Alright, okay, so now we can go to the next step. Now we just brought in a horizontal image. We can also choose to have a vertical image, okay, so which means the image will come either to the left side or the right side. Let's see how that works. I am going to delete, knock off this image. I am going to bring in a vertical orientation image. Oh yes, here it is. I am changing the dimension a little bit because I would like to see some borders happening around the image because that really enhances it. So I can either choose to have it flush to the left, or I can choose to have it flush to the right. But I would like to have it with some border happening, okay? And I want to have it on the left hand side, say for example. Okay, I have kind of balanced it, okay, and I'm going to push this back because my text box is half hidden. I'm having it here. Now the text box can be kept on the white area completely, aligning it to the image, or I can choose to have another image coming in. If I really think that, you know, another image will do justice to what I'm going to say, I can choose to have another image. So I just control seed this image and I control weed that image. Okay, copy paste. I am bringing it here and I am going to change this image. How do I do that? I right click on this image, choose change picture, choose another image. To me, it kind of, oh yes, let's push this image back. Okay, the text box is in the front and two images are doing a better job for me. They are communicating this quite well, right? Now we need to treat the image, the screen, a little bit. So what I'm going to do is to set these images in sync with each other, kind of align them together. I have chosen both the images, click on one image, press control and press the other image, and both the images are selected. I'm going to align them to the bottom. And for us to be able to align both the images to the center of the screen, what we have to do is to group these images together and make them one unit, and go back to the format, align the unit to the center. Okay, wow, it looks nice, don't you think? I am ungrouping these images, so they have become independent units now. I am aligning my text box to this image. I see that the text box is not centered, so I am going to center the box, text box, and it looks beautiful to me. All right, now just to tell you something guys, you can also choose to have some shadow effect happening for the text box if you want, or for that matter the images. So you get the additional dimension needed, but you can also choose not to have that. It is once again our personal preferences. Okay, I have unchecked it for the moment. So this is how the screen looks like. Got an idea? Now we are going to see how to animate these elements. We are going to see how to bring in these elements in some other way. There is another way by which we can bring in these images on the screen, especially for templatized situations, but that we will discuss. That one and the animation and all that we will discuss in the subsequent parts of designing the screen topic. All right, we will do that as we go along. For the moment, you can go back to your storyboard, open the story file and play around with some context, whatever that you are comfortable with. Play around with the images, get a hang of it. Once you are kind of cool with the whole thing, let's meet up in the second part of this discussion and take it from there. All right, so till such time that we catch up, it is Tata from me. Take care. Bye.